We started this study because we're interested in Alzheimer's disease, number one, but we know that the neuropsychiatric symptoms, which is a big long word, is a problem in Alzheimer's disease. And what am I talking about when I talk about that? I'm talking about the behavioral changes that accompany the disease. We know that it's diagnosed because of cognitive impairment, so problems with your memory and thinking. But along with that comes a whole host of other behaviors that are not the patient's fault. They're part of the disease.
Two of the most common symptoms in terms of the neuropsychiatric symptoms are depression and apathy. The problem with dementia is that as people become more impaired cognitively, they can't express how they feel. So, for example, people might be no longer able to say, I feel depressed, I feel sad, I feel hopeless. And so we need to find better ways to diagnose these conditions and these symptoms in people that can't express them from a language perspective. Apathy is also a very important neuropsychiatric symptom because it will interfere with the person's ability to perform activities of daily living, even if they still have the ability to do it. They lack motivation, they lack interest, they lack drive, and therefore they won't get up and get dressed. And these people will be perfectly happy sitting in a chair all day and doing absolutely nothing, even if they still have the cognitive abilities to perform these activities of daily living.
This is a really interesting study because we know that it's difficult to diagnose apathy in people with Alzheimer's disease compared to depression. So you know how they say that your eyes are a window to your soul? Well, they're also a window to your brain because what you look at tells people what you're thinking and what your mood can be. We know from previous studies in people with depression or mood symptoms that they tend to spend more time looking at images that we call dysphoric, so sad images. And people with apathy are more characterized by social withdrawal. So even in people who can't speak or who can't remember how they felt the past week, if you show them an image, that can tell you how they're feeling even when their words fail them.
So I'm going to calibrate your eyes. There'll be some dots coming up on the screen, so just follow them with your eyes, okay?
So what we've done is actually put images together using standardized images and have a slide that has two filler images, one sad image and one social image. And just by having a person sit in front of a computer screen, we can see what they look at using fancy technology called eye gaze technology. So they don't have to wear any headgear. We just focus on their eyes and we can actually calculate the amount of time they spend looking on each image.
So this will be the first time where we don't have to actually interview the patient, where we will hopefully get the diagnostic information by examining the patient without them having to say whether they feel depressed or apathetic.
Apathy in Alzheimer's disease is one of the most common and troublesome symptoms, not only for the patient, but for their caregivers. We're hoping that with this research, our ongoing research, and future research, we're going to be able to help both patients and caregivers deal with this symptom and treat it better.